Yes, I can hear. So all of you have received the YouTube link. I have mailed you also. Okay. So you will join with that, and there are two things that I'll show you. Three things basically, if I have time. One is beetroot permeability. Next is hydril experiment, which most of you are aware of. Another is plasmolysis in the real leaf, if you have time today. Otherwise, we'll do that next day. So, I've told you which page number to open in your lab manuals so that you can follow what is being done. A beetroot experiment is a very simple one, which you can also do it in your home. I'll tell you how you can do. So, today just observe it very, very carefully. Okay? And keep yourself in mute. Don't ask me anything right now. Whatever you have to ask, you can ask me tomorrow when we have the class. Okay? So don't ask me anything right now. Just follow the class. You can always ask me tomorrow when I have a class with you. So students, can I please see you once, as you know that you have to show me your faces once. And for the new students, this is our biology lab here. So welcome to the biology lab. This is our biology lab for the new students. Onnesha, Hemashree, Surbi. So this is a biology lab. You can see Krishnamurli ma'am there. Our vice principal ma'am, Krishnamurli ma'am. Students, can you please keep your unmute yourself for a second and just show your faces once, all of you. Krishnamurli ma'am wants to see you once. Yes, why such less participants? Where are the rest? Ask them to join fast. Shomudin, yes. So I'll just give you for the new students specially. This is our bio lab here. It's quite big, huge one, very spacious.
They can watch the YouTube live also.
Okay, and we will show you the YouTube live also. So after a long time, Boy Duchu, you are seeing the bio lab, Mirapro. All of you, okay, so you can put it off now. Please ask the rest to join fast. There's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 students. Please ask the others to join fast with the link.
6 are watching.
Yeah, only 6 people. So please ask, call up others fast and ask them to join, because we'll have very interesting lab class. Unless you join, there is no point in doing it. Join with the YouTube link. They don't need to join the Zoom, maybe. They can join only with the YouTube link. Please inform the others, all of them.
Start.
Good morning students, welcome to the biology class 11 practicals. Now, as I told you, today we'll be basically doing three things. One is cell membrane permeability of beetroot, hydrilla experiment for checking oxygen bubble evolving during photosynthesis, and also to see plasmolysis occurring in the rio leaf. So these three things. So first, since the beetroot experiment will take some time, we'll do that first. Now just check, what we will do is, which you can all do it in your home if you get a beetroot. If you can do it with a beetroot, because beetroot is dark red in color, and this color will come out with the when the permeability of the cell increases. Okay, so now I'm using a borer to make small pieces, but you can do it with a knife also. You can take help of your mother and do it with a knife also.
Seven.
So here This is a border. Okay, it has two parts. This part, one, and this another part. Okay, so how we use the border? Have a look very carefully. See, this wider part I am pushing inside this. If it is big, it will take a little bit of pressure to do it. Now this is one. See, this is coming out from the other side. What we have to do is, with this, we'll push the thing that you have bored out. So you will get nice cylinders like this. Nice beetroot cylinders like this. Okay. So I'll do it once more, so that you people can see it, or if they have joined late, you will be able to see this. So again, I am putting it here. To use a little bit of pressure here. Okay, it comes out from this side. Now you will push it and see the beetroot cylinders coming. Okay, so these are your beetroot cylinders. Now what we do is, with a blade or with a knife, okay, cut equal. Say I take roughly 2 cm equal cylinders. Okay, you can see I have made 2 cm equal cylinders. Now after making the cylinders, I will wash this thoroughly with running tap water. Okay, so just give me a while. So I am just washing this nicely in tap water. So they are nicely washed. Now I put in the test tube, I put 2 each. So I put, you can see, 2 cylinders in 3 test tube. Okay, now this 3 test tube that I put inside, I will fill this with water. Now that also I put equal volume of water in all the 3. Now what I am going to do is, one setup I will put in the ice here in the beaker. One setup I leave in the room temperature. Another setup I'll put in the water bath at 80 degree temperature. I'll show you how we'll do it. So initially I'll fill this 3 test tube up with equal volume of water. So all of them I filled up equal volumes of water, and I put two cylinders in each. Okay, so this one I will put here, okay, in this beaker, and I fill this beaker up with ice. This one I'll leave here in the room temperature, putting just normal volume, normal water, that is room temperature water. Okay, So I've just put room temperature water. Another one, I'll fill up water and I'll put this and put in the water bath, hot water bath. I'll show you how. Now you can see this one is our water bath. This one is a water bath. This is our water bath. This is the water bath that we have here, and you can see there is a temperature control here. Temperature control over here. Okay. Now this is load means I've set the temperature. You can see all at. You can remove this and set the temperature. Now I have set the temperature at 80 degree. Okay. You can see 80 degree. Now it is still orange because it has not reached the 80 degree. Once 80 degree is reached, this light will be off. Okay, only one main light will be on. So this light goes off as soon as it reaches this temperature. So I will not put my test tube directly like this, but I will put the beaker. I fill the beaker with water. 1 minute, I just fill it up. Okay, so this is the water in the cylinders. I will put this in this beaker and I leave this here at for 10 minutes. For 10 minutes after it has reached the 80 degree temperature. So this will go off. So after this goes off, it should be here for 10 minutes. So I'm just putting it there. And now I'm putting the ice also. Okay, we'll do that. We'll just put that. Till that time, till we put that in ice. Now this experimental setup, I put the ice here, of course. Now I'm keeping it here. What we will see, how much of that red pigment has leached out. So how much is the leaching? Now I have given you the page number of the book. I have shared the page number of the book from where you have to see. Now you will see there is a table at the back of the page. Okay? If you turn the page, you will be able to see the table where you have to write. Now there it is given 4 temperature, but here we will do with 3 temperature. That is at 0 degree, that is with ice, what will happen? Normal room temperature, which is about say 29 degree, what will happen? And at 80 degree, which we have said, 80 degree, what will happen? We will just write the degree of leaching, that is how much of the pigment has come out. In 0 degree, how much pigment has come out? At 29 degree, how much pigment has come out? So more or less, we will write down in this table. This is your experiment on the cell permeability. Thank you. So you can see that we have ice here. So I'm putting the ice here. So it is in the ice. We are leaving the ice setup, the room temperature, and already there is this thing we have done. So later we will check what are the outcome after 10 to 15 minutes. So in that 10 to 15 minutes time, I will show you 2 more experiments. One is the hydrilla experiment, which class 10 students have already done, but I am repeating it for the people who don't know how to do it. So we will take a beaker. We will take a beaker. We will take hydrilla plants. Now hydrilla plants here. We will take a few twigs of hydrilla plant. See to that you leave or remove some leaf from the top portion so that you can insert this inside the funnel. Now you are all aware of this hydrilla experiment you have done in class 10. So which we will do it once again here. So we have put hydrilla twigs here inside it, and we are putting it inside the beaker. Now what are the precautions when you put inside the beaker? You have to see that this neck of the funnel is below the water level. If it is above the water level, normally the bubbles will go out. So you have to see that it is below the water level and it is like this. Okay. Now we will take a test tube. Fill this test tube up with water. I'm just filling it up. So this is filled up to the brim. I put my thumb like this, and then I insert the hand below the water level so that the bubble does not enter, and I put first on the neck setup. After the setup, put the lenses. Okay, this is put it on the light source, and we have to count the number of bubbles coming out for 1 minute. We'll again wait for some time, again we'll count it for 1 minute, again we'll wait for some time, again we'll count it for 1 minute. We'll get 3 readings, and then we will make an average of the 3 and write the number of bubble, how much number of bubbles we got in 1 minute. Now for your demonstration, I have kept another setup already ready to show you that the oxygen bubbles had come up and it is pushing the water level down. You can see that the water level has gone down because the oxygen bubbles have come and pushed it down. Now another thing which we can do with this setup, which we might get in the practicals, that is if we add a spoon of sodium bicarbonate in both of them. Now if sodium bicarbonate is added in both of them, it's made a solution and it's added to both of them, what will happen? It will increase the rate of photosynthesis because it will give out carbon dioxide. And because of the increase of carbon dioxide, the photosynthesis rate increases, and obviously the oxygen bubble numbers also increases. So there also again we will count the number of bubbles per minute, 3 readings, and then do an average. And how the table should look like, I'm showing you. So you will draw a table like this. Here 1 minute, second minute and third minute. Here also 1 minute, second minute and the third minute. This is after adding sodium bicarbonate, and this is without adding. So just under the sun, under the light source. Come to say roughly say 25. I'm just giving a rough figure which might change. Suppose this has come to 27 and this has come to say 9. So what you will do is you will make another table, I mean here, and write the mean value. That is whatever is this A, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 by 3, and you write your mean value here. The same thing over here. Whatever you get, you will write, this is your mean. So whatever is the value at 1 plus 2 plus 3 divided by 3, and you write your mean value. Okay. So this experiment obviously you cannot do at home. Only those who have an aquarium or hydrilla inserted in them. You can see the bubbles coming up, but of course when we have proper school, you will be able to do this reading. But our class 10 students, most of you have already done this in class 10. So that was the second experiment for today, and the third experiment is plasmolysis. Now what is plasmolysis? You all know what is plasmolysis. It is the shrinkage of the cell content along with the cell membrane towards one side. Why it happens? If you put the cell in a hypertonic solution, since the plant cell has a cell wall, so it won't shrink. because the cell wall is there. But definitely the cell content along with the cell membrane will go to one corner along with everything else, that is cytoplasm, nucleus, everything. So this experiment we will do with a I'm sure you know what is hypertony, because in theory class also I was discussing about hypertonicity. So hypertonic is when the concentration of the solute is more in a solution. That here we take sugar solution, so where the sugar content is more than the water, so it is very concentrated. So concentrated solution is an hypertonic solution. And you know that hypotonic is just the opposite, that is dilute, means where the solute concentration is almost very very negligible or nil. Okay, and isotonic means both the concentrations are same. Isotonic means both the concentration is same. So here we are doing with hypertonic solution and we are doing plasmolysis with a rheolith. Now why we chose a rheolith? Because we don't have to put any stain here, because you can see, as you can see, the rheolith one side is already having anthocyanin, the purple color pigment, so it is already stained, so it is not required to stain it. So we will see to that when we just snap it like this and we take a small epidermal cell layer from the purple side. How we gradually just nicely pull it like this. Now you see that when you pull it, you get a little bit of membrane here, which you again pull back like this. So I have got the membrane like this. You can see this membrane. This is the cell. It is epidermal layer. So this epidermal layer, which has the cell, plant cell, along with the pigment, I am putting it in the sugar solution. I'll keep it here for some time to get plasmolyzed. Say 5 minutes time we'll give it for plasmolysis, so that the cell content shrinks. And after that we'll see it in the microscope. Now microscope, whatever you see, I will try and click pictures and send it to you. Okay, so we'll try and do that. And from your book, I'm telling you, which page is this? Now this is the first experiment that we have done is in page 40, where you have to write the object, experiment number one, object, requirement, procedure. And in the observation, that is effect of temperature or cell permeability, you will do only three reading, that is 0 degree, 29 or 30 degree and 80 degree. Okay, so that are your, and degree of leaching. Now degree of leaching, you have to write how much, which one will leach, and the precautions. So till there, not the note part. Okay, so that you will do. Page 39, our third experiment is from page 39. Page 55. Demonstration of plasmolysis. Okay, experiment number one with Rio discolor leaf. Okay, Rio discolor leaf that we are using here. You can use with onion bulb, you can do with a rose petal, you can try, but of course without the microscope you won't be able to see the plasmolysis. This is how you will observe it. So till the precaution you have to write and do the diagram. Okay, this part you need to do and send it to me. You know that very well, that it is in experiment number one. This is the third experiment. And page 44, that is a hydrilla experiment. Now hydrilla experiment, one thing is missing here, that is a light source. You have to draw three lines here to show the light source, which is not shown here. To write light source. Okay, this is oxygen evolution during photosynthesis, experiment number one. and till here, till the precautions, for all till the precautions. Rest of it not required. Okay. Now, let's go and check the permeability. Now, till now we have got, this is the ice one. You can see no leaching in ice. It's no leaching. The pigment is intact, has not come out. In the room temperature, you can see, if you see the bottom, you can see slightly leached. You can see that it is slightly leached. The pigment is down here. So there is slight leaching. In the ice, it was absolutely, there was no leaching. But here you can see slightly it is red down. That means it has leached. And let's go and check the 80 degree one. Now 80 degree one, you can nicely see that it has leached a lot. You can see that it is dark red color in the bottom. You can see it is dark red color in the bottom. And the whole liquid is also slightly, see nicely, the whole liquid is also red. If you keep it for a longer time, you can see the whole thing turning red gradually. So you can see the maximum leaching is in the 80 degree temperature. So you can see that. Let me show the microscope.
Trying now, you send the photo.
Okay, so microscope, whatever, now how to do the slides, I'll show you. Of course, the picture that comes, I'll share it with you so that you can see. Now, I'll just put a drop of glycerin in center to increase the optical density so that we can see it nicely. Now I take that Rio leaf which I had kept in the sugar solution. I spread it nicely. I spread this nicely. And then the cover slip, as you all know how to put a cover slip, but I'm showing you once again. You have to keep it in an inclined position like this. Keep the needle just below so that there are no air bubble. Now gradually as you release this, see to that the glycerin is spreading nicely. Glycerin is spreading nicely. Slowly, slowly, and then you let it spread nicely so that there is no air bubble. Yeah, and then I release the needle. Okay, so it is kept perfectly without any air bubble. You can see now I will clear the extra glycerin with a blotting paper. You can just see this nicely so that you can see the slide, how I have arranged it. You can see nicely spreaded and there's no air bubble here. Okay, there is no fold in the section. It is spread nicely, it is uniformly spread, and there is no air bubble. You can see that. And the extra glycerin that is oozing out from here with this blotting paper, when we keep it in the side like this, it will soak so that your microscope does not become messy. So we clear it and we observe it under the microscope, and you will be seeing the plasmolyzed cells. So after that we will put it under the microscope, and beautifully you can see the plasmolyzed cell. you will see that the purple color pigment are all present towards one side. Rest of the the cells are white color. Because as I told you that the whole cell content along with the pigment, the cell membrane, the cytoplasm, everything moves to one corner because of the shrinkage of the protoplasm, because putting into the hypertonic solution. Okay, so this is how your figures also look like when you draw the plasmolysis. It looks like this, where the pigment has all gone to one side along with the cell content. So the pictures properly, I will click the pictures and I'll share it with you. So we have done three experiments today which you will be writing in your practical files. First is the cell permeability with the beetroot. Next is the hydrilla experiment showing the oxygen bubbles coming out. And the third one we have seen the the plasmolysis with a Rio leaf. Rio discolor is a scientific name. So you have to write in with underline, you have to write the Rio in capital, discolor with D small and underline, which is the scientific name of this leaf that we have used. Okay, we can all do it with rose also, rose petals or any colored plant thing. We can even onion, we can do it. Okay. So that's all, student. Thank you for today. And
three of them.
Just a minute. Together, that is with eyes, no leaching absolutely. It's absolutely the way it was. With normal room temperature, you can see slightly leached at the bottom. Okay, and the hot water, you can see that it is very well leached. A lot of pigment is coming out, and the whole liquid will gradually become red. So the degree of leaching is much more with hot water than normal room temperature. And eyes, there is no leaching absolutely. These are the tables that you need to follow, and I've told you from the book also page number what you have to write. Okay, thank you students, thank you very much for your attention.